بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وحبيبنا وإمامنا وقدوتنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم ودعا بدعوتهم وسلك مسلكهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربي زدني علما Respective viewers, my beloved brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I welcome you all again into your regular Islamic program, Islam and Life, on 825 channel, Sky Channel IQRA TV. Respective brothers, this is the month of Rabi'ul Awwal, inshallah, we'll be talking about our beloved Prophet Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As far as Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is our prophet, he is our messenger. And as far as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned, we talk about our beloved prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 24/7 around the year, 365 days of the year. We talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We perform our rituals according to the way shown by Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We do our ibadah according to the way shown by Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, more or less, we talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We remember Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam throughout the year. But when the month of Rabi'ul Awwal comes, more or less everyone likes to talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more. Therefore, inshallah, in this today's program, inshallah, Islam in Life, we will be also talking about one of the unique topic, one of the unique quality of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the physical beauty of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my brothers and my sisters, I urge everyone to be tuned in onto this channel and this program, inshallah, and you watch and you promote other brothers and sisters as well to watch this program. And I repeat, the topic will be again the physical beauty of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You can watch us online as well, www.iqra.tv, and you can of course tune in into Sky Channel 825 as well, which you already have done, inshallah. And also you can ask your questions live, inshallah, we'll try to answer your questions. My brothers and my sisters, as far as Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned, he is the best of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the beloved prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, amongst the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has the highest rank. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Sayyidu Wildi Adama. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the leader of all the children of Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best of the creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with all the best qualities. However, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given one of the best of the physical appearance, which none other creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, none of the human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not grant that physical beauty as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's physical beauty was the most beautiful. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's character was the most beautiful character. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's habits, they were the best of the habits. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's lifestyle, they were the best of the lifestyles. Today, inshallah, we'll touch on the physical beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As it's a huge topic, it is impossible to just cover everything from every angle in this short period of time regarding the physical beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, we'll touch some of the ahadith where Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's beauty is expressed and discussed by many of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and my sisters, inshallah, we'd like to begin with one of the hadith of one of the great companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whose name is Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was the servant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was the khadim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Al-Madinah Al-Munawwara, Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was gifted to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by his beloved mother Sayyida Sulaym radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said that I stayed in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for complete 10 years. I came at the age of 10 and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away when I was 20 years old. So total number of years Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu stayed in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam complete 10 years. Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu in a hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari rahmatullahi alayhi, hadith number 3548, slightly Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu touches the and expresses the physical beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam laysa bit-tawil al-ba'ini. In this hadith, the first word Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu explains and he mentions regarding the physical beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He explains the height of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was not extremely tall. If a person is extremely tall, he is not a very beautiful person. If a person is extremely short, he is not of a very beautiful person. When the person is with the moderate height, with the medium height, this person is considered that he has a reasonable size, he has a reasonable height. As far as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is concerned, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not very tall, which does not look beautiful. Neither Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very short, which does not look beautiful either. So Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam laysa bit-tawil al-ba'ini. Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not extremely tall, that a person is really tall, he is does not look very beautiful. وَلَا بِالْقَصِيرِ. And the Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not very short as well. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his height, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him in a beautiful way, that neither Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was extremely tall, nor Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was extremely short. Because if a person is extremely tall, he does not look very beautiful as well. Neither a person, if he is really short, he looks beautiful as well. So Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not extremely tall, neither Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was extremely short. In fact, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was of the medium height. And the Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu talks about the physical beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the glow and the nur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the light Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had on his face. Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu talks about it and he says, وَلَا بِالْأَبْيَضِ الْأَمْهَقِ. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face was not just like white without any glow, without any nur and light on it. In fact, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face was kana azhar al-lawn. In another hadith, Sahaba expressed that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face was really illuminating. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face, it has a nice glow on it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face, it had a spiritual light on it. So Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wala bil abyad al amhaqi. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not just like plain white. In fact, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face, it had the glow, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face was illuminating. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's face, it had a lot of light on it. So Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, this is how Allah azza wa jalla created Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَا بِالْآدَمِ. And then Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's skin color was not brown as well. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam neither was just like plain white, neither Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was just like the brownish color. Then Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's physical color and the beauty was, in another hadith it explains that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was azhar al-lawn. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a very nice beauty on his face, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's skin's color, it was illuminating, it had a glow. Then Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu explains the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, وَلَا بِالْجَعْدِ الْقَطَطِ. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's hair, they were not extremely curly. وَلَا بِالسَّبْتِ Neither Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's hair, they were just straight. Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu explains that the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were not extremely curly, like they become like a spring. Neither Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's hair, they were extremely straight. In fact, in another hadith, it has explained that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's hair, it was a bit curly and a bit straight. So my respective viewers, as you can see, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has designed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a very beautiful way, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his physical appearance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the most perfect. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the most beautiful. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the most nice in looking. So Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu explains the height of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was not extremely height. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's color, it was not just like plain white, neither it was brownish. In fact, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's color, it was of the azhar al-lawn. It was very nice, beautifully made, and it had the glow and it had the light on the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Similarly, the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as well, they were not extremely hair. If a person has extremely curly hair, it is not also sign of the beauty. If a person has extremely straight hair, it is also not from the sign of beauty. If a person has the hair with a bit of curl and with a bit of straightness in it, that is considered as the beautiful hair. So as far as the hair of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were a bit curly and a bit straight. And the Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, this beautiful person, beautiful prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the beloved messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him in a perfect way. In fact, he was the best of the creation, the best possible way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and designed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another great sahabi by the name Sayyiduna Hassan ibn Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, when he talks about the physical beauty of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in a poem that أحسن منك لم ترى قط عين وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب كأنك قد خلقت كيف تشاء. Sayyiduna Hassan ibn Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said that O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no one has ever seen anyone more beautiful than you, and no mother has given birth to anyone more perfect and more beautiful than you. As if O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب, you have been created free from all the faults, Allahu Akbar, in your physical appearance, in your spirituality, in your character, there is no fault, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ, you have been created free from all the faults. And then Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala, Sayyiduna Hassan ibn Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَى, as if O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have been created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the design you recommended for yourself. So this is the physical beauty of our beloved Prophet Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and my sisters, we have to go for a short break for Adhan of Asr Salah inshallah. Please be tuned in and inshallah continue watching the program Islam in Life, and inshallah after the break we'll continue with the topic, the physical beauty of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and inshallah we'll take your live calls as well, and inshallah we'll try to answer many of the brothers and sisters, they have forwarded some of the question through the social media to us as well. Inshallah we'll try to answer them inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Please be with us after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.